been up to?
I've been riding on a daydream.
Hey YouTube, thanks for checking out RV Daydream, and today is a big day for us because this is one of the first steps of our downsizing, but it's also our yearly garage sale, and we're going to start tearing all this stuff apart. I get the camper open because it rained pretty hard and the awning's a little bit wet, but there's some things that'll be going in the camper and not going in the camper that is going to go under the awning. Back of my truck needs swept out so we can put stuff back there. Heidi's already started down here in the garage. Heidi, you've already started cleaning up. She started cleaning up in the kitchen, but it's supposed to be 87 today, and I said, why don't we start in the morning when it's nice and cool in the garage and outside, and then when we get a little bit too warm, we can head back indoors. But I've got so much junk out here. What we're trying to do is, this is where everything's going to go to be sold. So we need to sweep it out and clean it up and straighten it up as much as possible. Then go through all this crap and start pulling out quite a bit. My problem is I've got a lot of parts for mowers and that in here. The bottom two shelves are mower parts. This shelf here is automotive. This up here is for tools for woodworking, basically. And I don't normally get in those cabinets that often. Then in those cabinets there, it's almost all moped parts. Up here, I don't even know what's in these cabinets. There's some battery chargers up there, but a lot of this stuff needs to go. We've got stuff up here in the rafters. Most of that is supplies and tarps. Then once we're done in here, going through everything after the garage is swept out and we're starting to stage stuff out here, we got to go into the two sheds. I have a little storage shed over here that has quite a bit of stuff in it, and a lot of it can go. We're actually considering just letting this shed go. It's actually a crate, believe it or not, that carried an industrial piece of equipment for a shop from the 70s. And then they just put the wood exterior on it to make it a shed. So it's got like a metal floor, and underneath that OSB is some up and down treated boards like you would find on skids. So it's a pretty sturdy shed, but we just have it filled with odds and ends that don't need to be. And we gotta go into this shed here, and that shed, although it's beat up pretty bad, it's a really good shed. It needs to be gone through and a bunch of stuff come out of that. Once we do all that stuff, then we can go in and start messing around with the basement and all the rooms of the house. What do you say, Heidi?
I'm excited.
Yeah, she's excited.
Dirty already.
Yeah. So we'll go ahead and jump into this stuff, and we got deliveries coming from UPS. I'm going to have to be doing some reviews here shortly of some items that we picked up for the RV. I'll be doing an install for the RV, showing how to install a couple things. And a lot of action going on in the next week, so stay tuned, and we'll show you a little bit further along once we got this garage thing a little closer to being sorted out. Wow, do we have a bunch of junk. Heidi's over getting lunch at Subway because we live real close to Subway, and it's that time. But look at this crap. All this stuff you see is just from this one shed. But this shed is finally empty. So we'll probably sell this at the yard sale. We'll tell somebody they got to move it. It's a good shed. It used to be a crate, like I mentioned before, for machinery. And then they built a false wall on the back of it and put a door on the back because they used to keep the coal here. That's why it has a metal floor. The house used to be heated with coal. They would fill this with coal, and all this wood here goes into these slats, and you can stack it up as high as you want. Then as you need coal further down, you take away a board and set it off to the side. Actually, you put it up in the rafters here. So this thing's been around a while, but it's sinking because the foundation wasn't that great. And then all this crap here, I'm going to get rid of that moped frame finally. There's a couple wheels for a roller on a garden tractor. You got those on Craigslist. And you can see, same back here. This is the backside. Then they used to keep some of the equipment as far as gardening stuff. I can't believe how much crap was in that one little shed. So we got to find a place for that, get rid of most of it. We want to get rid of that shed. And then we got to clean out this shed. Now some of this stuff is going to go in this shed from the other shed. And that would be like some of the house supplies, the shingles, vinyl siding for the garage. a lot of this wood's going to have to come out of here. I'm going to see if I can talk Heidi into maybe getting rid of the yard trailer. Her grandfather built that years ago, and it was over at her brother's for a while, and now it's back to us. You can see this big, huge, heavy roller that's back here. It's filled with oil, and it's real thick plate. I mean, it's definitely bigger than 3/16. It's just heavy. I just know it's really heavy. But we got a lot of stuff that needs to come out of here. A lot of gardening stuff. Stuff we haven't used in years. Figurines for the garden. There's some lanterns back there of some kind. Just all kinds of stuff. And then there's some stuff up here too. But a lot of this wood I've just been hanging on to for projects and that. And I use it occasionally, but it's getting to the point where I don't know. If you guys looked at my other channel, Fox Boss 9, here's where I was experimenting making braces for the cross braces or trusses of the roof when I replaced the roof on our camper. So some of that wood was used. And that's the problem. I have a lot of stuff here that I still use occasionally, but a lot of it's for projects and the house. If we go full-time RVing, I won't need all this stuff. So we need to start dwindling it down now. All right, we'll come back with more of an update and hopefully more junk. I think I'm gonna let it go for a little while so you guys don't have to see every little step, everything that we clean out. But once this stuff is all piled up in the garage and maybe when we're starting our yard sale, we'll get into it. As I mentioned in the previous segment, I'd wait till we're a little bit further along. Well, we're further along. This is our first day of the sale. Heidi's making the money, aren't you, honey? Look how red her face is. It looks like you got a lot of sun already.
Apparently. Yeah. We have a lot of stuff.
Yeah, we got a lot of stuff. Some of this stuff was donated, kind of, by friends, but... And the sad part is, this is only part of it. Now, you're not looking at much here, I know. This bed's daughter's old bed. Heidi's old car, we're gonna get rid of it. It's been sitting for a while. But look at all this crap we got. Holy cow. Got the camper awning out for some shade for some stuff. And here's the sad part about most of this. We still got a lot of stuff to go. We don't use our lantern anymore since I got those rechargeables, so our poor lantern served us well. We're gonna have to get rid of that. All kinds of crap. Electronics. My very first toolbox right there. That's an 80s edition. That was my very first toolbox. Kind of cool. This is a 1963 Philco Stereophonic. These speakers are detachable. Just wanted to give you guys an update. This is what it looks like when you start downsizing. Man, do we got a lot of crap. I'll come back with more info later. So it's a little bit later in the day. Heidi had a eye doctor's appointment to take to her son too, so that's where she's at. And we're getting some of this stuff sold. Let's see here. Still a lot of crap. And Heidi said I should show more stuff that we have. It's nice, we don't need a home phone system anymore. I did a review on this on my other channel. I love these phones, but there's no need for them any longer. This is kind of cool. I don't know if anybody RVing, if this will work out for you, but you can actually put your TV outside, even if you don't have hookups, and this will give you hookups to plug into. It will send the signal wirelessly, and it does a really good job. I've had that for quite a few years, and the reason is I didn't want to run cable from this porch all the way from the room in the back of the house. So what I did was use that to watch the Cleveland Indians game years ago. These are nice. Scrub the hell out of stuff with this. They will clean wheels, everything you imagine, your bathroom. This has a very high torque motor in it. I mean, you can't really slow that thing down. If I put a scrub brush on it and put all my weight on it, it still wants to turn. It's geared that way. It's called a scum buster. Really cool thing. We still got a long ways to go. This is the first day. Heidi didn't really want to have this on Sunday. I told her with all the work that it took to get this stuff out here that we're definitely having it on Sunday. And in turn, I told her we may even have it on Monday. This is kind of cool. I'll show you something else. Cool, huh? It's a stun gun. It's got batteries in it, but they're a little bit weak. But it's kind of cool. How many times you go to a yard sale and buy a stun gun? Wait till some kid comes along and tries to buy it, though. Not happening. Oh, just so much stuff. So many things to do. Well, anyways, I'll close it out, and we'll pick it up a little bit later.
All right, here we are, day two of the extravaganza. I got a different camera that I'm trying to shoot with, so we'll see how they sync with the first one. You can see this one here is not a angle like the old one. It's a more conventional angle. Everything's tarped up. Yesterday was a moderate success. It was a Thursday, so we didn't expect a lot, but we did want to get it started, and this got that done.
All right, so this is it. We've got day two just starting, and hopefully the money will start rolling in, but more than that, the stuff will start rolling out. We've got to go through some stuff that's actually inside the house yet. Whenever I went down and took a shower last night in the basement, I noticed we hadn't gone through hardly anything. So Heidi, I think, is going to run and get some donuts, and we're going to get at it. Hey, YouTube, here we are on Saturday. This should be a big day for the sale. Yesterday was a pretty decent day, and you can see some of the stuff is gone. Show you here as traffic goes by. I slept in. Heidi came out and got this stuff all ready. See tarps blowing in the wind because yesterday they had some moisture on them when we put them away. But you can see a lot of stuff is gone, especially up there. Some of our bigger furniture was gone, like that bed. That's kind of nice. But we're slowly getting there. We contemplated carrying around all these movies when we went camping, but it's just so much easier to put them on a storage device now and just pull them whenever we need them. You see here, here's some vintage stuff. Look at this. When's the last time you've seen stuff made in Japan? These are actually all glass. It's kind of nice. This is kind of cool. It's some sort of potato masher strainer of some kind. And here's the funnel that you put it in the jar with. This is a real nice glass bowl. These glass bowls go with that set there. They're heavy. Check this out. Double ringer horseshoes. And they're marked for each player. And then the original instructions that came with the set. I wish we still had the box and the stakes, but that was a long time ago. We were thinking about using the stick broom in the camper, but nope. Bunch of albums. And a lot of the electronics are still here. It's kind of funny because I thought that stuff would sell first. A lot of odds and ends off this table have gone. Lots of odds and ends off this table have gone. Again, I'm surprised. My lantern's still here. But here we are. There's Heidi. So that's our update for today. And hope all the rest of this stuff goes. Just a few more big items. Like that shed. You got that shed for $100. Somebody gonna come by and pick it up. That'd be great. All right, that's it for now. This is the end of the day. You can take a look here. We're all tarped up for the most part. And it was a pretty decent day. Our friends seemed to sell more than we did, which that's okay. It's all good. We've got quite a bit of stuff that's gone. We get a couple of other big items that we like to get rid of, and then a lot of this stuff, we'll see what we can do. Some of it's Craigslist items we can put on eBay. We just wanted to see how it'd do here first. But just wanted to check in and let you know that was it. We're one more day after today, Sunday. We're going to try that sale, and I think we'll be done at that point. So we'll check back in and give you an idea of what we did. Hey, YouTube. Welcome back to RV Daydream. And this is Sunday, the last day of our sale. You can see we still have a lot of stuff left. We've gotten rid of a lot of stuff, which I'm really happy about. Some of this stuff, it's kind of funny with yard sales. Some of the stuff you think would sell right away don't sell. And other things that you wouldn't think would be wanted by anybody is gobbled up right away for whatever you ask with no questions. We would like to get rid of that big furniture piece out there, that lounge, that corner lounge with that ottoman. That'd be nice, so I don't have to put that away. But yeah, this is all that's left here.
it's just kind of funny that people's junk is other people's treasure, just like the saying goes. I find that some of the things that I wouldn't care anything about, people want, and other things that I care about or think that's really worth something, people don't care at all about.
We're getting close to getting most of this stuff gone, because a lot of this stuff that's left over, we probably won't see again. I'm not saying that we're going to throw it all away. We donate a lot of stuff. The clothes go to a consignment shop. It's called Kid Zones in the area, and what they do is they, you know, if it's good, clean clothing, which all of our stuff is, they put it on consignment, and then they just have an account there. As far as all the other stuff that is metal that may or may not be worth anything, I'll set that up for scrap. We'll take that to the scrap yard, which I got quite a bit of scrap at this point. And then there's a lot of older stuff that is kind of sentimental that we may hang on to, like the classic bird bath. Heidi remembers when she used to play in that when she was just a little girl, as tall as the bird bath. So basically that isn't going to be sold for much less than what they're asking. But everything else I can put on Craigslist. Some of the stuff I can put on eBay. I just wanted to try this first because this gets rid of the majority of the stuff. And the other thing we're coming to the conclusion of is we're thinking that we may want to keep this canopy. It is so sturdy and it is so stable. And when you compare it to something like that, which that's Heidi's brother's, we borrowed that for a little bit extra shade. That thing gets the job done, but it's so spindly and it's hard to set up, and it's, like I said, it does the job, but this thing does the job and then some. So we were thinking if we ever get to a campsite or something, that maybe the awning can't go out, because if you recall that last campsite we were at, Lock 30, you know, the pine trees were relatively close to the camper, and we had to position it just right to where the opening of the awning was in a clearing area, that there was no trees that were involved. Now, if we would get in a campsite that there might be a problem with that, this canopy would be the solution. We'd just be able to set it up and move it around as we need it. So it's a thought. It is awful heavy though, and I'll have to see how much room's in the back of the truck once we get further down the road. But yeah, we're setting up this for the last day, and hope that most of this stuff's gone. Well, I'll let you guys know what we did total as a group combined as far as money went out, and you'll see if it's worth it or not. So far we were going to make a lot of money, so I don't think it's worth it, but oh well, it's something to do. Hey YouTube, all right, here's our big update. We're all finished, aren't we, Heidi?
Yes, we are.
Look how burned she is. Look.
And the funny part is we were underneath the canopy for the most part, but that's the early morning sun for getting us. So we put everything away. I'll show you that now.
You can see we still got a bird bath and still a little bit of stuff. Heidi's got her car full of stuff going to Goodwill. All this stuff here that's on this pallet is going to a local buy sell exchange place. Let them take a look at that stuff and see if there's anything that they want, and then that stuff is going to scrap. We got the camper all closed up because we're going to burn our wood,
so we got to burn some wood tonight, and we're all done. So what was our grand total for all this trouble? Well, I don't really weigh it in money value because we only did about $648 over the 3 days, but, or was it 4 days? Anyway, $648. Well, we got rid of a lot of stuff. We did move quite a few things. We did, unfortunately, still have that sectional, so it's back downstairs, but the nice thing about it is it's happening. So, first step. I'll go ahead and get this stuff posted for you. Hopefully it's not too long and not too boring. And we'll come back with more later. I've got some reviews coming up, so stay tuned and hope to see you out there. Thanks. Bye.
Say bye, Heidi.
Bye.
Bye, guys.